Hi everyone, welcome to another headphone.ph video review. Today we have the Atemotic ER4 SR reference in-ear earphones from Atemotic. Let's jump right into it. So Atemotic is really more known as a hearing aid company rather than a consumer product. And they've been making hearing aids for the past, I think, more than 20 years. They made the ER4 headphones back in the 90s, if I'm not mistaken. And they've rarely changed or updated their earphone models. So the ER4 SR is an update over the ER4 P. That they've released more than 10 years ago, and as a hearing aid company, it's really not their focus to continuously update their products or their earphones, to be specific. And so we have the ER4 SR here, which was released alongside the ER4 XR. So the SR in this earphone stands for Studio Response, which implies it's used for studio purposes. The XR stands for Extended Response, which is really just having that earphone having more bass. So this earphone originally costs $350. I think the price has gone down to $299 as of late. So it's definitely an expensive little earphone. And unlike like most earphones, this is an earphone that looks more like a hearing aid than anything, really. Like, if you can see, it has this, I don't know if you can see, but it has this really long nozzle or tube, and you know, it requires deep insertion, which we'll talk about in a bit. It comes in a nice simple box. This box is, I think, more consumer oriented than the previous ER4P models, which I'll show in a bit. So it's got this nice presentation to it, and inside you'll find the I've obviously taken out the headphone already. It comes with this certificate of authenticity, which is basically they call it certificate of performance, but basically you'll see that, you know, each of the headphones are measured and signed by one of their audio engineers. So this is very reassuring, especially since we know like there's unit to unit variants of some headphones. And with this one, you know that you're getting a headphone or an earphone that is consistent with other models. The other things inside the box is this nice like carry case. Inside you'll have, like, Atemotic is known for providing a lot of accessorization, so it comes with a ton of tips. So you can see here they've got a bunch of other tips. So they have this like foam tips that is like a comply tip. They have various sizes of triple flange, which is the recommended tip. And they also have the I think this is the filter tool. So the filter, the way this works is that once you have the filter inside the tip of the headphone, once it's dirty, you can remove it and replace it with the filters provided here as well. It also comes with a 1/4-inch adapter. So Atemotic headphones are known for, not sure if you can see it, they're known for being not so efficient, especially for an in-ear monitor. So they always provide this one. And it also has this like small carry pouch, which is nice for like transporting the earphone when you're commuting. So you've got this bigger box that holds everything, and you've got this smaller one, which is just for the earphone itself. As mentioned, I thought the packaging is more consumer oriented than the previous one. So the previous one looks like this, which is more like a toolbox kind of thing. So this is the previous model, the ER4 PT, and personally I kind of like this one better, although I appreciate the smaller footprint in this case. Now onto the build. So the main difference between this and the old ER4 PT is the housing is now machined aluminum, or by machining the aluminum. So the old ER4 I think is made of plastic. It also is now detachable. So let me see if I can detach it here. So as you can see, it's now detachable. It connects using this MMCX connector. So it means that when the cable sort of malfunctions, you can easily like get aftermarket MMCX connectors and you're good to go again. I still have the ER4 and I think the cable quality of this one is better. It's not rigid and doesn't hold its shape. It's fairly flexible. I think the braided part here is also thinner but still as sturdy, and I can feel it's a very sturdy cable. So all in all, I think there are some improvements in terms of build for the ER4 SR and XR in comparison to the old ER4 PT, which I've owned as well previously. The one thing that sucks with this earphone is that there is no clear identifier of left and right. So there is an embossed letter L and letter R that has the same color as this part here, so it's black on black. So there's absolutely no way you can see it in the dark or even in bright daylight. So Edimotic's been known to have this like really long housing here, and as a result, like it requires you to have really, really deep insertion. And if you've never had deep insertion of earphones, then it's not like anything you've experienced. So some people call it ear rape. It's probably a joke, but basically, in order for you to get the best possible sound out of this, you have to sort of like really, really insert it deeply into your ear canal. And the test that you can make here is that if you're wearing it and if you yawn without hearing yourself, then that means you've done it well. But you know, if you're hearing yourself, it means the insertion is not deep enough. Basically, this tip has to reach the bony part of your bony section of your ear. So I know not a lot of people are comfortable with deep insertion. It doesn't feel natural for sure, but I've owned Edimotic headphones since 2012, 2013, so I'm used to that kind of feeling. As a result, you're rewarded with fantastic passive noise isolation, because you know, you can't even hear yourself yawning, which means you know, you're gonna be able to really isolate yourself from the outside noise. I think it's very comparable with noise canceling headphones. Obviously, with the noise canceling tech, it's able to cancel out like higher frequency noise that this one may not be able to cancel. Still, it's got a very good like broadband noise isolation. So this is a perfect headphone for commuting or anything that would where you're required to cancel out noise. However, keep in mind that situational awareness is still important. Now onto the sound. So I've been upgrading or buying Edimotic earphones for a reason, and that's because I like how they're tuned. They are very neutral sounding earphones, which means they don't have any accentuation in bass. They are very detailed as well. So the ER4 SR, I feel, you know, if I'm gonna summarize this earphone, it's a very neutral yet not lean or cold or clinical sounding earphone. So a lot of times when you have a headphone that is perceived as neutral, they tend to be clinical, or what that means is it's very like unpleasant for just like listening sessions. So that's not the case with this headphone, I think. So for me, I find that this headphone has fantastic balance, good coherence, and overall just clean sounding. So provided that you're able to really get a good seal, like deep insertion to your ears. But even with that, the bass of this headphone is not the Harman bass. So It's definitely bass light in today's standards. That is without a doubt. But the bass speed of this little earphone is exceptional. So there is a distinct advantage whenever you're wearing something that isolates you from the outside noise and hearing details. So comparing it to some of the open headphones that I have, you know, with open headphones, if you're not in a quiet environment, you're, you know, not gonna hear all the details because you're hearing like outside noises. With this one, because it isolates you very well from outside noises, you don't hear anything aside from the music that you're listening to. And as a result, it's easier to really discern like every small nuances in the track with the Air 4SR. So I think the bass speed of this earphone is fantastic. It's not, you know, it's bass light, but at the same time, you still hear the details. There's just not that much quantity. The impact is a little soft. It's definitely not a bass that will have a lot of like visceral impact. It's more like a slap, really, like a dynamic slap than a slam. However, it's really a astonishingly fast bass. So some of the there is this track from Dream Theater called Beyond This Life, the live version, where the bass in one of the guitar solos are just amazingly fast, which it's not something that I can hear in my other bigger, even full-size headphones. So the bass is like, if you can get past the lack of quantity, you'll appreciate the detail that, you know, this headphone puts out in the bass department. The mid-range of this headphone is pretty spot on. It's a little forward, around the 1 to 2 kilohertz, so it may be a little shouty for some, but for me, I like the way it's implemented in this earphone. So the vocals are very alive, they are very in your face, and the quality is, for me, is really very good, because the mid-range is also, the upper mid-range is also a little forward. There's very good clarity in, you know, guitar instruments, piano tones, and things like that. The one description I can give to this earphone in that category is it's very clear and clean sounding. So there's not any hint of like unevenness or any hint of boxiness in that area. And also the upper mid-range going to the treble area is not fatiguing or harsh at all. So Atomotic is known for having a good treble resolution in their earphones, and the Ear 4SR improves it even more compared to the last model, which is the ER4 PT. So I feel like the treble here is smoother than the last one. The last one is also smooth, but tends to have this, I think, fatiguing quality to it after some time. With this one, I feel like it's even smoother, like easily comparable to some open headphones that I have. I mean, the Clear, for instance, has good like treble resolution. This one, I feel like, matches the treble resolution of the Clear. Obviously, the Clear has like better other things. Like, for instance, it's got a better space, being a larger headphone and an open headphone. So maybe it's not fair to compare this little gem right here. And speaking of soundstage, the soundstage in the ER4 SR is nothing to write home about. It's very earphone sounding. Still, I feel like there's some small improvements with the soundstage of this one compared to the ER4 PT. I feel like there is the soundstage here is slightly like deeper than that model, and like going like side by side, back and forth between the two earphones, I feel that this one has a better overall width. The depth is pretty much the same for both earphones. So imaging is really good with this headphone. I think the only thing that hampers it a little is the lack of a bigger sound. I feel like if the sound stage of this one is bigger, imaging is going to be even better than what it you know, currently is. The Ear 4 SR is kind of inefficient for, especially for a small earphone in such a small form factor. I find that it benefits significantly from external amplification. So if you have an amp like the Shit Magni 3 or the JDS Labs Atom, I feel like that's gonna help, you know, this earphone perform better, like basically have a better sense of nuance in all frequencies, like better detail retrieval, even a bigger, slightly bigger bass than when just using it straight from your smartphone. So without a doubt, the Edimotic Ear 4 SR is an audiophile earphone in that it's, you know, good at detail retrieval, it's got good imaging, it's got like, save for the lack of bass, it's got a good frequency response. So I feel like this is the old frequency response of like old audiophile tonality, where the bass is not, you know, that elevated and is slightly lower in relation to other frequencies in the spectrum. If you like bass, I think you'll have to take a pass on this one. Again, it's not, I don't think it's like lacking in bass. I feel like it's something that's overstated too much. Like if you get deep insertion with this earphone, there is bass, there is like, you can hear the bass, it's just not, the quantity is just not like a lot. So, you know, it's not like you're missing a frequency or a spectrum, it's just, it's there, it's just not as pronounced. So and I understand and respect that some people don't like that. But for me, the bigger issue, potential issue, I think, is comfort. So the deep insertion is definitely not for the majority. It's something that is not, doesn't feel natural and takes some time getting used to. And, you know, you can try out other foam tips that they include in the package. But the thing is, the triple flange is the best sounding amongst all the tips that they're provided, and that feedback is something that's shared by almost like all users that have this earphone. So if you think you're gonna like this earphone, it's either you get used to that, you know, deep insertion, or you get a custom like mold by going to your audiologist. So Edimotic suggests, if you live in the US, they suggest some audiologists that you can go to, where you can like get a custom mold for your ears. That one provides much better comfort without losing that same like sound quality that the Ear 4 SR provides. So what are the other options that you have at the $300 range? Well, to be honest, I haven't been using earphones that much in the past, you know, half a decade, but I can say that there are some offerings from Shure. I think the SE535 and Westone, where it is sort of the opposite of the sound presentation of Edimotic, where that one has, those options have more bass, slightly less treble frequency, so the tilt of the frequency response is like downwards tilting as opposed to upwards tilting with the Ear 4SR. That's about it for the Edimotic Ear 4SR. Do you own this earphone or are you planning to buy it? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comment section below. Thumbs up the video if you like it, subscribe for more headphone.ph video reviews, and visit headphone.ph for the text version of this review. I'll see you guys next time.